Can you believe in one Borescope now? You can get a 360-degree articulating camera with a 5-inch viewing screen that's 1080p. The inspection light camera itself has 6 lights. The cable's only 6.2 millimeters, so it can fit in some really small crevices. With that 360-degree articulation, there's almost an endless view that you could get without having to work hard to see it. The cable itself is even IP65 waterproof. It has 3x zoom. Let's get this thing unpacked and try it out. This is like medical quality in your hand for a couple $100, plus there's a big coupon on the Amazon link. You got to check this out. As you look over some of these features quick, we want to give a special shout out to our tool sponsor, Jeseral. They were our official Borescope tool of the How to Wrench and Tools Wrench Shop in 2024. We loved their product so much when they reached out in 2025 with this new model. We didn't hesitate for a second. And after getting it, boy, they came into 2025 swinging. This thing is feature rich. Let's go.
Nothing to take away from the old units that we've had. They have been doing nothing but serving us great, but wow, technology advances.
Before I go into these individually, I wanted you to see them side by side and really see what the differences are. So the new one on the left has more of a joystick style lever. Once you insert the Borescope into whatever you're looking at, you can really just use the joystick lever to access whatever you want to see. Now the old one, while we had no complaints, you could put it in the hole and you could go 180 either way, but you had to like rotate the cable to maybe get the view that you want. Like I said, not a problem. They're just the difference of the two. It's going to be much faster with this new one where you, boom, you just go in and just basically start aiming at whatever you want to see. Wouldn't ask for anything more. And then they send us this thing. The first thing I'll say is how flexible the camera cable is. That's going to allow me to get into places easier. The same 6.2 on the spec, but I liked this one. So I'm just going to have to use it to see what I think. But definitely can really get into some tight areas as you kind of wiggle up through. This might have been nice on that video that I did going up into an air box. So being super flexible like that. Comes with the usuals, comes with a manual, super nice case. Obviously, you could get rid of this foam. It's more of a shipping foam, but it's not bothering me right now, so I'm gonna leave it in there. Comes with a manual, of course, some certification, cleaning cloth, a USB drive to immediately run to your computer, charging cable, and a cable to go from, where did I see that? This one's new. This cable is going to, so this will be interesting. The molding on this case is out of this world. I mean, it is just exactly precise. Let's see. Let's get this baby in there. Nice. Okay, if you remember before, this one just mounted, and then the model before this one, you would take this and then clip it in. I use one like that similar at work, and I like them all for different reasons, but let's go ahead here. Let's have the thrill of pulling off the sheet. And then what we have now is from the wand, we've got a USB. And then I tried this when I went to charge it. Come on. And there's two USB ports. So there's a charge port and then the port for the camera. So I guess what we'll do is we'll just go in the lower one first. Let's go ahead and power this on. Okay. All right. Hey, there I am. The thing that I noticed right away is it's really nice to not bump the record button. So this is a little more protected. I like that. And then let's see how this light feature, oh, that pushes, has like a downward motion here. Off, 1, 2, 3. So 3 different light positions. I'm gonna be on full bright. But here's what's different about the new model, my friends. 2025, they're gonna blow us away. On this one, we have full articulation wherever we wanna go. So now we don't have to be so intentional when we go in the hole because we're just going to be able to get this thing wherever we want. And then we still have that, let me go here. We still have that full bend. Look how tight that'll go. It's literally going beyond itself. Look at that. It's shooting along the side and back. You can imagine what a great view that's going to get. I'm going to go ahead here. Stop taking that video. Let's see what happens when I just click this, you know, one time, for example. I could hear it like a shutter, like taking pictures here. See if you can hear that. You'll notice when you take a photo, it's going to tell you here on red, successful screenshot. And then we could go through the menus here. I'm sure we could figure out there's a photo. Let's go. These are all different photos I took. You could see them going back and forth. Let's go back to that one video. Play that video. I would go, okay. It's playing the video. You could see the pause button there. If I hit okay again, it's going to shut that video off. That'd be a way for you to know that you hit it correctly. There's another JPEG. So I want to get out of there. I want to go back to live action here. Okay, there I am. Let's go get inside this gas tank and see how bad it is. Wow. The acetone is helping. I'm trying to remove the liner on this, and this tank is in such bad shape from somebody putting a liner on that didn't stick. You know, it's just a bummer when they put these liners in and they don't get them dry, typically is what the problem is. It makes a mess for the rest of us. Take a look at this chunk that broke loose. They must have not poured out the excess liner. And I'm going to go ahead here and use a grab tool at the same time as the borescope to get it out. How cool is that? This thing was so big, I had to carefully break it into pieces without creating any dents in the tank. This is by far the hardest one I've ever done. I have no idea to know what brand liner this is or if it was OEM, but it surely clogged up that fuel filter. The photos of when I diagnosed this to begin with, how bad the fuel valve was plugged up. This caused them to break down on the side of the road, actually. I got some more work to do to try and get this old liner off before I put the new one on. What a super pain. Serious thing, if you have anything flaking on there, it's not going to do what it's supposed to do. I want to show you with a little practice how controllable this joystick is. So once I get stabilized here, you're going to see I'm able to come up along, make little micro adjustments. A little more adjustment. And I can follow that pipe all the way to the top. I'm looking back at myself. I mean, that joystick is awesome. I'm actually going to do a full video on this because it's so impactful on how borescopes save you a bunch of money. But for this video, let's just look at the quality. So I've went into this cam case area that you would otherwise not be able to access. Let me get flipped around. And as I rotate that joystick around, boom, I'm right at the part I can see significant wear and know that I should continue on. Look at the quality of the chain and everything you can see in that view. The lifters here, let's look at those. I mean, pretty amazing ability to get inside there. Watch the full video where I explain why this is so valuable to save yourself a bunch of money. People always seem fascinated to see inside an engine when I do these borescope videos. So here's another one, good for my customer as well. But you see the carbon buildup on that. Go ahead and flip around here. Start to use that joystick and look at the head. The piston was all the way at the top, so let's switch cylinders. Get into this one, down a little bit more. You can see that crosshatch, valve cutouts. Let's go ahead and flip around and look at that crosshatch. Awesome. Awesome. She'd run a little rich though. But we can flip up here. Give it a second to focus. A little more crosshatch. And look at that, that is the edge of the valve. So you can see how the valve seat is right there. Carbon on the head. Crosshatch and a cylinder. If I wasn't timing the motor, I would have lowered the piston, but way cool. Let's look at our display and our function buttons right here. So I've got that SD card ready to go in there. I talked about the two USB ports, the bottom one being a display makes sense. It's closest to the camera, and then the other one being a charge one. I didn't get the display to work when I moved this to the top one. I only got it to be able to charge. I want to show you something. If I power this on, hold it for a couple seconds, get power on, and it goes right into like, oh, cool, it's working, right? If I hit my mode button, you're going to see I have no file because I don't have the SD card in. So if you missed that, that's what you need to do. So now that we have an SD card, we can actually look at the files on there. That's a real good catch to check that your SD card's in there before you get to a bunch of work and realize it's sitting back in the office in your computer and you can't record any videos for your customer or yourself. So let me show you how to get into the settings. Once you power on the unit, I'm going to simply push the middle button here. And that's going to move me into the different kind of settings I can do. I think these are pretty standard, so I'm not going to go through them all, but use your arrow keys here to get into what you want to do. What I want to do right now is I want to format this SD card. I thought this would be a good example to show you that. I've chosen my down arrow. I'm going to hit OK. Do I want to format? I'm going to use my arrow keys to get over. Yes, I want to format. Now, this can erase everything on that card. I'm going to hit OK. Get back out of there, put it back to just the nominal display mode. And if I go into mode, you're going to see I have no files anymore. So that is how you format your card. I recommend that you format that card before you ever start using it, especially if it was a used card, because things could just not work and you'd miss all the footage that you intended to get. So format your card first, use it. And then once you've transferred those files, I like to just get rid of them. I don't know how many videos you could put on a 32 gig. I think it's going to be quite a few, but to me, my workflow is once I transfer them, I'm just done with them and I get rid of them. All right, I want to go back to using the Borescope, hit the center here, and I can be back in shape to go back and start using my tool. Now, if I go back to this mode, you could start to see there's some files. If I hit this arrow key, you're going to see I could trigger through those different files, right? Once I'm on a video, you actually got to come over to OK to play it. And you'll see that goes to a play button instead of you. It seems like you want to hit this middle button, but if I do that, it's just going to move me back to being able to use the Borescope. So I would need to be here. I would hit OK. I could go ahead and watch this. I don't have to pull the SD card out and go to a computer. You could see the timer's going. It's moving on its own. To stop that, I can just hit OK again. If I want to toggle through anything, I can go up or down here to get to the file that I want and then go ahead and view it. When I want to go back to using the Borescope, I'm going to simply hit the center button and I'll be good to go. That's a real quick overview of the functions on here for the display. The other thing I wanted to point out is, let's say you were ever having a problem here. There's a reset system, but there is also the little traditional reset button on the side here where the charging cables go in the SD card. A little right there. And then another couple of cool features that you got the ability to do the date and time. And what you want to do here is you'll just keep, once you're on that, you can hit the arrow keys up and down to get it. And then just toggle OK to go to next, 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 go here. And then it'll close you out of that. Another thing that you could do is you could choose where you want the date tag in your video. So maybe if that were really important, if you were using this tool for like evidence where dates and times really mattered, that'd be a good way to do that as well. Next, let's make it clear the functionality of a couple of these buttons. So number one, if you want to use the light, you can push down on this. I found that using my thumb like this and just cycling through, you have three different brightnesses and then you can shut completely off. So we have one at full brightness, middle, lowest, off. That's how that's accomplished. Let me show you the differences between taking a still photo or a screen recording. For still photos, you're going to just tap that trigger and then the display screen will show successful operation and give a slight audible click. In a long hold, we'll turn on the video. And then you'll see a timer starting at the top. To shut off the video, I just tap it one time and the video will shut off. All right, my friends, there you have it. There's our full feature intro of the 2025 Jeseral 360-degree articulating borescope. We got purchase links below. We will be making more with this like we always do each year, but we want to appreciate Jeseral for teaming up with How to Wrench and Tools to Wrench. Don't forget to click that $95 coupon and get one of these in your toolbox. We are loving ours. Make it a great day, and as always, like, share, subscribe, and keep wrenching. Thank you.